Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. In this episode, I want to talk a little bit about mutation testing. And as you can possibly see from the screenshot up here, I interviewed with Rob Alex Denisoff back in 2019. So this has been more than 5 years of the recording of this episode about the concept of mutation testing. And there's a bunch of mutation testing frameworks out there today, but in the last 5 years, I still haven't taken the chance to actually play with one. So I've installed Mull and I've given it a try, and we're going to cover that in today's episode. Now, of course, I have to remind you that my name is Jason Turner, and I am available for code reviews and on-site training. And you should check out the video description for more links about this episode, upcoming events, t-shirts, books, all those great things. Okay, this is Mull. It is an open source project that operates as a Clang / LLVM plugin. I'm not going to go into great details on how to actually set it up and install it and that kind of thing, but I will just say if you have Ubuntu or another Debian-based operating system, it is pretty easy to install because they provide official packages.debs for you. So after messing around with an Ubuntu install that I happen to have still lying around as a WSL install, in fact, I was able to get this set up and running pretty quickly by simply following this set of instructions where I added the new apt repository, I updated, I did the install. It didn't quite catch a couple of dependencies that I needed, like the LLVM lib stuff, so I had to install like libclang and whatever, but then things were working pretty smoothly. And since it operates as a plugin for LLVM, you kind of have to do some funky command line stuff here. So clang -f experimental new pass manager -f pass plugin, and then you have to pass this mull ir front end whatever - clang version that you're using. It needs to match the version of clang here. And also I'll point out that this doc is currently incorrect. It says user local lib, but if you use the official Debian package, that's actually installed in user lib. So that's a minor change that I had to do as well. Let's go ahead and jump into the actual example. I've got this very simple setup here, and I haven't even like fully configured my NeoVim or anything, but I've said exclude doctest.h in the mull.yaml file. And this is important because you don't want it mutating and testing your testing framework or other libraries that you happen to use. And of course, at this point, I haven't even explained what mutation testing is, but that's what this example file is for. So I've got testmull.cpp, and this is an incredibly simple program. I have this, which is stolen, if you will, from the Hello World example from the Mull website. It's just a function that tests for a valid age. If your age is greater than or equal to 21, which is the legal drinking age in the United States, which might be what this is a reference to, then it returns true. Otherwise, it returns false. I am including doctest here, and I've got this doctest config implement with main so that it automatically adds a main for me. Now, note that I have added a test case. One way that I have heard mutation testing described, and I think it might have been by Alex, it's been a long time since that interview, but everything in there is still valid. I would go check that out if I were you. Some people would say that you can use mutation tests to write your test for you, and that is what we're going to actually experiment with in today's episode. So note, I have this test case. It is literally doing nothing. This is almost like the evil opposite of test-driven development, in a way. Mutation testing. We need to take a moment to describe what it does. The general idea is that it goes in and it changes things like comparisons in the code being tested, and then recompiles and re-executes the code to see if your test cases still pass. So I have if age is greater than or equal to 21 in here, and all my test cases pass. Well, my test case isn't doing anything, but it passes. There's no errors being thrown here. So this is going to pass no matter what. If the mutation engine comes in and changes that to if age is less than 21, it's still going to pass. And this is what is known as a mutant that survived. And when a mutant survives, it means that your tests don't test the things that you think they test. So that command line, which we already saw, looks something like this. I'm calling clang++. I'm doing that new pass manager. I'm adding the pass plugin for the mull IR. That's mull intermediate representation. This actually works by mutating the clang IR. And then dash G to add debug symbols, and the C++ file and the output file goes to test mull. And I can just compile that real quick. And then there is a mull runner. Like this, mull runner 12-IDE-reporter show killed. We kind of want to know the things that survived or not, and we'll get a little output here. So I'm going to run this. Now, if I didn't have that mull config YAML that I mentioned earlier, we would have gotten a whole lot more output here that would have had all of the testing framework also being mutated. And so this is warning me that I have a mutant that survived. It replaced greater than or equal to with greater than, and the test still passed. And then it replaced greater than or equal to with less than, and the test still passed. Okay, so let's go ahead and modify this, and let's go ahead and put in a couple of test cases. So I'm going to check that 22 is a valid age, and I want to check, no, let's just do that. I want to check that 22 is a valid age. And I rerun this, and it tells me that this one killed, so this was a mutant that did not survive, that it replaced greater than or equal to with less than, and so that was a good test. But then it says it replaced greater than or equal to with greater than, and the mutant still survived. Okay, so let's go ahead and add in a test here to say, check that 21 is also a valid age. So what you can see here is that the mutation testing engine is basically helping me narrow in on the corner cases in my test suite. Now it says all mutants have been killed. So it tested this. It was able to replace the greater than or equal to with greater than, the greater than or equal to with less than, and this worked. These mutants all died. There weren't any surviving mutants. But we know that we still have a couple of cases that are not correct, right? So if we don't have any negative test here. Okay, so this is definitely a case that it was not able to find, which is, you know, an experiment, right? So mutation testing is one more tool to add to your set of tools in your C++ testing toolbox. There you have it. This is a simple and short introduction to mutation testing. And the point is that it goes and mutates the code being tested to tell you if your tests are valid. I would definitely recommend playing with this and trying to roll it into your own test suite. There's several different options, and they all have ways of integrating with your build system so it can become a part of your normal testing environment that you do. Although you might think of it a little bit more like fuzz testing, maybe not something that you run on every single build on the CI, because there could be lots of things that it would need to change here. I definitely need to give this a test with some of my larger C++ projects and see how things go there. And perhaps I'll report back on that in a future episode. Thanks for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. Hope you enjoyed it. Be sure to subscribe.